right, guys, previous video, we got an overview of the project. We saw the cinematic that we're going to try to create here together. In this video, we're going to do a little bit of project setup. I promise it's going to be very short, actually, just so that we have some content to kind of play with to create our scene. So let's go ahead and get started. Again, we're using Unreal Engine version 4.12 for this tutorial series, but you could use any version, 4.11 or later should be fine. So we're on the Unreal project browser. Let's go ahead and go to the new project. We're going to use a blueprint, blank blueprint project. You can enable or disable starter content. It's completely up to you. We're going to use no starter content. We're not going to need it, so we're going to turn it off. Then go ahead and give your project a name. We're going to call ours Forge. And hit Create Project. It'll take a second just for it to load up. And what we're going to do next is import some content from the marketplace, which is available for free. So I'm going to drag in the Epic Launcher here, Epic Games Launcher. And we're going to go to the Marketplace tab. And we're going to search for some Infinity Blade content. Now, you may have used this before, this Infinity Blade content. If you have not, Epic Games has provided quite a bit of free content from the Infinity Blade series that you can use in your projects or future projects as you'd like. So the ones that we're going to be using are the Infinity Blade Adversaries, the Effects, and the Firelands. Those are the three that we're going to be using. So I'm going to click Adversaries and add them to my project. Make sure that I add them to my Forge project. And let's go back and add the effects. We're not going to be doing too much effects work, but there's one in here that we're going to use just to show you how you can do it. So I'm going to add that to my project. Go back. Let's add Firelands. It might take a second to download and get it installed and implemented in your project. Once it's done, you should see all of those assets inside of your project here. The next thing that we're going to need to do is get our hands on the audio file that we're going to use to score our scene. So I have a web browser here. I'm going to show you where you can get your hands on that. You can use any audio that you'd like, but if you'd like to use the one that we're going to use, you can go to purple-planet.com/drama. And this is a website that has some royalty-free music on it. There's some disclaimers about how you can use it on here. Most of the time you can use it for free as long as you link back to their site, but you can purchase licenses if you'd like. But we're going to be using one from here just because I thought it sounded cool. I'm going to be using this Battle Lines track. You can preview it here by clicking this button, but you can kind of hear it. Sounds pretty intense, so that's going to be the one that we're going to use for our scenes. I'm going to pause that so we don't have to continue listening to it just yet. And I'm going to click this button here to download it. Don't need to sign in or anything. You should be able to just download it right away. So it's downloaded it in an MP3 format. So we're going to have to convert that, actually, so that we can import it into Unreal, because Unreal only supports WAV importing. So we're going to have to make some edits to that. You could use any editing software that you may have. If you don't have any, you could use a program called audacityteam.org/download. So Audacity is a program that you can use to do some free audio editing. So you can use this program. I use it quite a bit for some audio editing. Get that downloaded and installed if you don't have one, so that we can convert our audio asset to a WAV format. Once you have it, open up Audacity. And for that, all you're going to need to do is take the MP3, just drag and drop it in. And we're not going to be doing anything in here, just File, Export Audio. And it's going to export it as a WAV. Make sure you choose WAV. Hit Save. Don't need to do any tagging. Just click OK. And then we can close this out. And it should have did it to the desktop, which it did. All right, so now we can import this. And inside of Unreal, I'm going to do some quick folder creation just to keep things nice and neat. In the content browser, I'm going to expand the sources panel. On the content folder, right click, new folder, call it audio. I'm going to add one more folder, actually. Right click, new folder. We're going to call it cinematics because we're going to place all of our sequencer related assets inside here a little bit later. So in the audio folder, take the Battle Lines wave, drag and drop it in. And once it gets in, it's imported as a sound wave, which Sequencer does support. We could use just a sound wave, which is a direct copy of this file. However, we're going to make some modifications to this file inside the editor with a sound cue. So I'm going to right-click on this and convert this to a sound cue, or create a sound cue from it, I should say. And that's all we need to do. And naming convention's fine. We'll leave it as is. So let's go ahead and save all. So. And that's actually all we need to do. There was one other thing we're going to do just to get the ball rolling on it. We're going to go to the Infinity Blade Firelands and the Maps folder and open up the Forge level. So this might take a second if this is the first time that you've opened it. Mine opened a little bit quickly because I've already opened it on this machine, but it might take a second to load all the textures and everything in. But this is the environment that we're going to be working in. This is what we're going to create our scene in. And it's lit and everything's nice and pretty for us, so this is what we're going to use. And that's actually going to do it. That's all the setup that we need to do. We're going to pause here. In the next video, we'll talk a little bit about Sequencer, give you a quick introduction to Sequencer before we start getting our hands dirty and creating our content. So we're going to pause here, and we'll pick it back up in the next video.